Miss Ando. Oh, how are you?
Good morning.
Nice day today.
Yes, it is, isn't it? Aluminium foil too. This is metal, you know. It's not combustible.
Really?
And glass. You need to put this in the glass bin. Okay. I don't know why people just don't understand. They always put these things in the wrong place.
Sorry, Miss Ando.
Oh, no. It's everyone. Oh, Chloe, you have finished cooking.
Yeah.
You have a lot of oil left.
Yeah.
You know what to do with the oil? You need to soak it up in some paper.
Oh, really?
It's better if it's kitchen paper, but for now it's okay.
I don't know about that.
It's okay. Yeah, okay. Better. Good. Or else it clogs up the waterway, you know?
Okay, thank you.
They don't want it to clog, so yeah, do that. Mm.
Okay, thank you, Miss Ando. Those crashes, this Ando was complaining about them. What should I do?
Hi.
Hi.
Are you new? Do you need any help?
Yeah, I don't know what to do with the crashes.
I'm sure we can help. So, what you have here is the combustible rubbish bin. Basically, everything goes in there, except for some rubbish that has to go in the shed. But we can show you what goes there.
Okay, thank you.
So firstly, we have cardboard boxes which need to be folded and dried and put into the cardboard bin. But make sure you have removed all of the tape and packaging. Next, we have batteries which go in their own special little rubbish bin right here.
For the PET bottles, glasses and cans, you need to wash it, remove it, and then put it into the corresponding bins. And whenever they have the caps and the labels, make sure to remove it. And for the PET bottles, you have to also crush it. Plastics belong in the combustibles.
And so lastly, we have incombustibles for dangerous, metallic, and glass objects. So we can put umbrellas, metal foil, empty aerosol cans. But make sure that if you have anything dangerous, like broken glass or ceramics, that you wrap it first and label it as dangerous before throwing it away.
Reduce, reuse, recycle!